I wanna be lost in you. swept away. Draw me close to only you remain. Let the things of earth be swept away. Draw me close. Overwhelm me, take. casting out all fear. Your perfect love is 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 casting out all fear. Casting out all fear. You're casting out all fear. Draw closer to the one who is love, who is love. All my fears fall away, they fall away in your perfect love. As we draw close to the one whose name is love, whose name is love, and every fear falls away in the light of perfect love, of perfect love, of perfect love, of perfect love. Love without condition. Love without condition. So is your love. So is your love. Love without condition. Love without condition. So is your love. So is your love. cross in the heart of the one whose name is love, whose name is love. I want to get lost in the heart of the one whose name is love, whose name is love. I want to get lost in the heart of the one whose name is love, whose name is love. I want to get lost in the heart of the one whose name is love, whose name is love. I want to get lost in the heart of the one whose name is love, whose name is love. I want to get lost in the heart of the one whose name is love, whose name is love. I want to get lost in the heart of the one whose name is love, whose name is love. I want to get lost in the heart of the one whose name is love, whose name is love. You give life, you are love, you bring light to the darkness, you give hope, you restore every heart that is broken. Great are you, Lord. You give life, you are love, you bring light to the darkness, you give hope, you restore every I love.
Nothing compares to this. At the name of Jesus,
Jesus, every chain will break. At the chain of Jesus, every knee will bow. And at the name of Jesus, every chain will break. At the name of Jesus, every knee will bow. Oh, at the name of Jesus, every chain will break. At the name that is above every other name. The name that is above every other name. The name that is above every other name. Name that is above every other name. The name that is above every other name. Song we could ever sing. You're worthy of all the praise we could ever bring. You're worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. Jesus, a name above every other name. Jesus, the only one that could ever save. You're worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. Show me who you are.
Jesus, there
silence the boast of sin and grave. The heavens are roaring the praise of your glory, for you are raised to life again. You have no rival, you have no equal, now and forever, God, you reign. Yours is a kingdom, yours is a glory, yours is a
stand in awe of your name, the powerful name of Jesus. You are King of kings and Lord of lords. And yet you ask us to come and draw near. We stand in awe of how you can be powerful and worthy and yet compassionate and desire us. Come to you. You are worthy of it all. We lay it at your feet. You have made us worthy in your sight. Thank you, Jesus. We'll be going into a time of intercession through prayer topics. Tonight we'll be praying for Israel. Specifically, we'll be praying for Israel to be firmly established fully in her identity, to know who she is in the eyes of the God who has chosen her. Please come into agreement with me as I pray along with the prayer points on the screen, and then raise intercession with your own voice as the Spirit leads you to pray through each topic. Faithful God, you are the keeper of promises. You have promised your people Israel that you will never let them go. You have promised to be their God and that they will be your people. We declare the current sons of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, relying less on strategy and might, but turning to their inheritance, the promise that they have for their sense of identity and justice. You are their God. Over and over and over, you have longed to gather them, even in the midst of their shame, even in the midst of their running away. Desire to draw them in. God, we pray that you would renew the faith of your people, Israel, that they would cry out, "We are your people and you are our God." Let your promises come alive as the scripture is read in synagogues and homes all across the world. Breathe life on your word. Let scales fall from the eyes of those who for generations have held to the words but have not understood your love that emanates from these words. We declare the truth of your promised provision, your promised justice, your promised peace and rest and salvation. These are not broken promises, and your people are not abandoned. No matter what it looks like now, with strife at her borders, we declare that the promise of the land of Israel is her inheritance. God, though it may seem foolish, to accept the word of a God who has said the same thing through the centuries, no matter what they see now, let your people hang on to the truth, the promises that you have given them. We prophesy men and women following after you and declaring boldly, we are not rejected. God is pleased to make us his own. Let them walk boldly with confidence as those who have received a promise that cannot be swept away. Let's pray.
People, you are our God, you are true.
love them with an everlasting love. This nation that you drew out of other nations, that as you called them out, you desired to just be with them. You have chosen Israel as your own. You have made her the apple of your eye. You have longed for her. You have gone after her. You have drawn her in with your love. I thank you that your faithful love has chased your people through history. That by covenant, you established your people as worthy. And you've been jealous for her to know her worth ever since. For so many of us, you have revealed a greater and greater depth of your perfect, unrestrained, and unmerited love for us. We call out this same understanding, that deep would call to deep in the hearts of your people, Israel, that they would know this unrestrained love you have for them, this desire you have for them, that her worth does not come from what she does. That as a nation, she is worthy because you have chosen her. As individuals, they are worthy because you have chosen them. Lord, raise up key leaders in Israel with the testimony of your love. Religion and ceremony, to know your presence and your love because you love them. We declare that you are still pursuing your nation. You are still pursuing Israel. In this nation that you've chosen, you will pour out your perfect love, whether she answers or not. God, I pray that you would be softening hearts. Let your word speak. Pour your love over your people in the land of Israel, scattered all over the globe. God, let your people know your heart. You long for them. We pray that you would stir that longing in your people. Turn to you, to look to you for their worth. Let's pray. declare that you are the God of your people no matter where they live. That your nation cannot be bound by borders. That every believer, every child of yours, every son and daughter of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, wherever they live in the world, the promises are for them. Your promises are true. You have been calling your exiles home for generations. We pray that any of your people who have been called back to the promised land, but they have been reluctant to go, that you would work your miracle in hardened hearts to soften and stir, that they would receive your grace and your promise. We denounce all lies of illegitimacy or unworthiness in the hearts of the Jewish diaspora. They are yours. Their inheritance is full, it is sure, for they are full heirs of the promise. God, we pray that you would uncover lies and fears that are keeping your people from returning to the land of their promise, the land of their inheritance. And as you draw your people to yourself, let them come with thanksgiving and joy. You've said, even if your exiled people are at the farthest horizon, that you will gather them. You will bring them to the place that you have chosen as a dwelling for your name. We declare revelation and life blown into the words of your promises as they are recited at the tables of families, in the synagogues, your people hear these words with new, fresh ears. Let them see them with new, fresh eyes. And for those families who have been called home generation after generation, we pray that this generation would be the one to break the cycle, that they would return to the land if their family is called. We pray that in Israel there would be an opening, arms wide open to welcome those home. God, we thank you that you have given the promise to your people, that the promise stands, that you desire to be with them. God, draw your people. those who belong to you as the nation you have chosen. This church, this bride, these called out ones. This church holds a place in your heart like no other. You have chosen her and she is worthy. She's also surrendered all and said yes to be with you. God, I pray that your messianic church would know who she is, that she would rise up in the royal authority that she has, the inheritance that she has of your promises, the grace and the salvation that she has. Lord, use the mouthpiece of the Messianic Church to speak your love and salvation to those who are walking on the border of knowing you and belonging to you, but not fully surrendered. You've designed this church to be a testimony like no other. God, let the church worldwide openly honor the Messianic Church. Honor them as your chosen people and those who have surrendered their lives to you. And in every nation where the Messianic Church exists under the threat of persecution, under the threat of anti-Semitism, protect your people, protect your church. Give wisdom and grace to continue following the truth that you said and not just what they see. Give them strength and mercy. God, we stand with the Messianic Church. We stand with those who belong to you and have surrendered themselves to you. God, bless the Messianic Church all around the world. The movement of the church to find herself a mouthpiece to those who know your word in part. For so many of them in the Messianic Church, their testimony is that they have known about you. They have known your word inside and out, and then you came. God, we pray that you would continue to come. You would continue to use the testimony of the Messianic Church to show your love for all of mankind and for your nation of Israel. God, speak to your people through your people. Thank you. testimony of Israel, that through this nation we see how a God desires to be with his creation, that you have done everything. You have made the covenant to make them worthy, that you have surrendered your life, that you have surrendered your son in order to regain the destiny of your people. God, we desire to see Israel walking in her true and full identity as a worthy nation, as worthy men and women, because you call them worthy. God, continue to draw your people home. Continue to send them out with your voice. You see the end from the beginning, and you see where this is headed. You know where the promises end, and it is beautiful. God, I pray that you would show your people, you would awaken your people to the destiny of the promise that they received, the truth of the promise they received, this kingdom that cannot be shaken. They have inherited, and it is theirs. Encourage your people, God. Draw them to yourself. And cause us to honor those that you have chosen to be worthy. In Jesus' name.
Love that you've displayed for us, the pursuit with which you've chased us down. We thank you, God, for your saving grace, for the way in which you continue to advance your kingdom. We trust that you continue to work even tonight, as we lift up our voices in worship and in prayer. We thank you, Father. You're a God who continues to move. You listen to the prayers of the saints. You're a God who fulfills every promise that he has said. We thank you, God, for the sureness of your word. We trust in you. We look to you in all things.